After all that fun, cleaned off the GoPro, and I'm gonna stay further back from Joe so I can see what the heck's going on. Cause I just fell into a giant hole. What's happening, guys? Today we're back out in New Mexico with Mr. YamaJoe. Unfortunately, Katie has a petcock issue. She's got a crack in her petcock, so she's leaking fuel, which is not good. So YamaJoe is actually YamaJoe today. He's riding his dad's Yamaha 350 from 1986. As you can see, we are riding in sand today, so today is going to be a lesson in sand riding. So hopefully I don't die. I'm not the most experienced sand rider at all. But I have the fundamentals down, and hopefully this video can help some of you guys out that are like me, that were looking for help when riding in sand. This stuff's slippery.
What's that?
It's fun, but it's slippery. Be careful, dude. So the key to riding in sand, keep your weight back, always stay on the throttle. And it'll push your front tire right through. Stopping is still kind of hard. And so is tooling at slow speeds. But going at constant speed, you want to stay in the higher RPM range. And she'll just slow right on through. It's kind of cool. At first, you want to go really slow like I did. It's not good. The faster you go, the more stable you are. And I'm not really fighting her. I'm just letting her do what she wants to do. Oh, apparently this is another motocross track. That's the other thing we're doing today, is a tour of motocross tracks. Oh, that's a hill. Go for it! Oh, there's a balloon over Albuquerque. That's what they're famous for. Watch out, Leo. I don't know which way he's gonna come back. I wish we had those Cenas. gonna go up this way. I made it up. Yeah. Right on up there. Big ol' ugly, slippery sandy hill. Oh. Standing up or sitting down seems to be just about the same. Lots of garbage out here, Everride. Is this the jump? Is that the jump?
Yeah, that's my intro.
That's your intro? Yeah? If I go right up there on the side, what's on the other side?
What?
Alright, so I'm knocking the airs. I'm gonna go up there and sit there, check it out. Don't wanna pull in airs. Especially out here where it's all freaking washed out. Oh yeah, it's perfectly flat. Aside from all kinds of trash. Are you gonna hit it? No. I understand, he's not comfortable on that bike. He said he's ridden it a total of 4 miles before we let set out today. So I completely understand. Not kosher. Yeah, Joe! There you guys go. CDS special for you. What would you give him, Miss Stacy, out of 10? I'm gonna give him a... We're giving you an 8. Eight.
Why?
8 out of 10.
1 out of 10.
You were a little sideways.
That was on purpose. Let me do it again.
All right. That doesn't look safe. Here we go. Yeah. All right. That was a 10. That was spot on. 10. Yeah. Right on, dude.
That's scary on this bike. Because it doesn't feel like it's going fast enough.
Really?
And Katie's like,
and she's just like, bah!
I feel like they're going fast.
Yeah.
I like that.
See it? Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're landing. Yeah. Cool. That's far.
That's about 40 feet.
Well, there you go. Here's a reenactment of YamaJoe's intro on the 86 Yamaha Tree Fitty.
It doesn't feel right on this bike.
Well, don't kill yourself.
It sounds a lot better than the Kawasaki.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like I can ride a lot. I'm a lot more comfortable in the sand. The slow moving is harder, but like cruising down the roads, I'm not scared anymore.
Yeah.
As long as I keep like third gear almost wide open, it's all about keeping it in the higher RPM range is what I found.
Yeah, just keep the momentum.
The front wheel just kind of does.
It
just does what it does. All right, cruise some more, the man says. Whoa. Yeah. Those are some big whoops, man. Big whoop. Just got a tractor through here. I'm heavy, Zena's heavy. We're heavy. Well, it's a little too fast. This is like, holy crap. Come on, Zeta. See, the fun part about this is I'm just letting Zena do all the work. I'm not doing anything but sitting on the rear tire and hanging on. Hey, baby. Mwah. This is deep. Some YamaJoe stuff. What everybody likes to say, this is some YamaJoe stuff. CDS can now officially say, whoa, that he's ridden YamaJoe stuff in YamaJoe's backyard. And of course, YamaJoe is gone. But same thing, high RPMs. Let the rear tire do the holy crap. Come on, Zena, hook up. Kind of fun. Whoa. Zena is just plowing. Oh. Man, that is deep. I'm still not confident enough in my turning to go next to Joe. But you just kind of hang on, you go. She'll take the turns. My speedometer is covered in dirt. I have a feeling everything's gonna get a nice washing when we get back to Colorado. But again, I'm really bummed that Ayers couldn't come out. He's not feeling well. He's supposed to be out here with us doing the damn thing. And unfortunately, he's not doing too well. Nothing life-threatening or anything. That, Miss Stacy now has audio. She's got audio on her visual. This is pretty awesome. I know Joe probably wants to go hit big-ass jumps and stuff, but thank you very much, Joe, for... being kind of nice to us. Oh, I just did a little YamaJoe spin there. That was cool. Uh-oh. That wasn't yours, was it? That wasn't your bottle, was it?
No. This is where I broke my arm.
Oh. Okay. So this is where Joe broke his arm.
Yeah.
Where were you jumping? Way up over there?
No, the closer one.
Can I ride up to it? Is it safe up there?
Yeah, just don't kind of jump it.
I won't. Don't worry about that. Whoa. I'll try and at least go forward. It was right. Whoa. Oh, so you were went down here and were jumping that way?
Oh, yeah, jump over the top.
Yeah.
My front tire hit that hook on the far side.
So I was talking to Joe and just getting a few more tips to try and pass along from somebody who's been doing this their entire life. And my question was slowing down and stopping. It's just kind of a shooting match. Going, not so much of a problem. Stopping is a problem. He said you just gotta kinda do what you do when you're going. Stop and let her go. So we're going 55 right now, which should be terrifying, but it's not terrifying at all. Actually feels great. Like I said, I would not call myself an expert at all, but compared to the first time I ever rode in sand, which was over at Rainbow Falls on the burn side of Rainbow Falls, that was really, really frightening. And the reason it was really, really frightening was because I was in first gear doing 15 miles an hour and had absolutely no control. I feel like if I went over there right now, you know, minimum is going to be second gear, but really preferably third gear. And let third gear just haul you through. I mean, I'm in fifth right now, and I'm just kind of trying to stay out of Joe's dust. It doesn't really taste that good. Oh, yeah, there you go. New Mexico dust. It tastes just like dust everywhere else. YamaJoe! Yeah! Nice!
I've got a great idea for a video. CDS, why don't you crash right there?